Hi, and welcome back to R for Statistics and Data Science. In this lesson, we will go full circle and complete the stellar saga of importing and exporting data in R. So, we have our data, we have done some manipulations, and we want to share our work with others through Dropbox on a flash drive, preferably without giving our whole computer away. To save your data into a shareable CSV file, you use write.csv with write.csv2 version for those of us who use a comma to denote a decimal. And to save data into a tab-delimited text document, you use write.table. Let's export our Star Wars data from the first lesson on data frames and dissect what's happening. If you need to recreate it, I have put the code right here so you can pause and copy it. Obviously, the first argument we pass is the data we want saved. Then we specify what the file name of our data should be once saved. It does not have to be identical to the name of the data frame. But be careful. R is a little literal sometimes, and for everything to work correctly and for your file to actually save in CSV format, you would have to specify that by providing the extension .csv in the file name too. Okay? Okay. Finally, and this is important, the row.names argument should be set to false. In addition to literal, R can be a little buggy sometimes. If you save a file with the row.names argument set to true, it will add an extra column in the beginning of the table marking each row from 1 to n, guessing that your actual first column is the names of the rows. But wait, you think, that doesn't sound so bad. Yeah, but it is. Because if you reopen the file you just saved, R will somehow have forgotten it has saved it with this additional column that marks the row numbers, and instead will consider the numbers to be part of your data. And congratulations, now you have a column you very much do not need. Repeat that a few more times and you will end up with n number of redundant columns and nothing to do with them. In conclusion, adding the row names argument and setting it to false is going to save you some unnecessary work. Okay. I promised a short lesson, and that was it. Thanks for watching, everyone!
For more videos like this one, please subscribe.